Welcome to another episode of RuPaul's All Stars 3 Review with Nick. This is Nick's Nerd Network, and I'm Nick. So, I'm sure you'll notice a couple things are different about this video. I don't have Jane Elias with me. A little bit of background information, and also an apology for this video being so late. I was overtaken with an extreme case of the flu on Wednesday, and I was not able to attend Drag Race night, and Jay Elias and I discussed it and said there really wasn't a lot to discuss about this episode, so I should probably just do this episode on my own, and then we'll resume with regular episodes at the start of next, or after the next episode, or the finale for All Stars 3, and then go straight into season 10. So, now that I'm better, it's Monday today, my fever finally broke, and I'm feeling okay to do this video, so I'm going to try to keep it short, though, because I don't have a lot of energy. So I first wanted to talk about what I thought about assigning the roles throughout this challenge. So they were assigned the challenge of the Squirrel Friends. I'm not going to say the whole title because it was absurdly long. Well, first let me talk about the concept in general. I really felt like it was mashing too many ideas together. A lot of the challenges have been really strong this season, and I really felt like this challenge was an afterthought, which it's not great because Bendela's gone and they kind of lost their like front runner, and then it kind of seems like this challenge was lazy, so there's a lot to be longed for with this. But Morgan, she was there, she got to assign the roles to the different girls. I don't know, Trixie made some comments about how Morgan made the wrong choice for herself and assigned herself a worse role. Trixie initially wasn't happy with her role but ended up doing really well with it. I think that the girls all had great promising roles. I don't think anyone had more of an advantage. I mean, Trixie was kind of the main character, so I don't know why she was upset about that. But I do feel like they didn't make some of the best choices when working with the characters that they had. So, in terms of the performance in general, Morgan, she could have done so much with that beige swan. She really could have. I mean, having the opportunity to play a crazy person, that allows you many opportunities to steal the show. I thought that Kennedy, again, wigs were getting in her way. I think she's very acrobatic and she was very talented and she did some great things, but the wigs were her downfall. She was getting her eyes, it was slowing her down, and I agree with the judges. It was kind of just one-note performance of, look how high I can kick my leg and rhyme some words. I don't know if they were assigned those lines, but it kind of felt like those were made up by her. I think that overall the queens did not perform so well in this challenge. Trixie was probably the biggest highlight. She did really well. they said that they gave Shangela some good responses, but honestly, she kind of just had the same one-liners of just like, mm-hmm. Like, it was good, it was funny, but I don't think that they can complain that other queens were performing on one note and not call her out on the same thing. But you never know, it's editing. So, I think in terms of who performed the best in this challenge, it was Trixie. I honestly don't think I could pick a second best. I mean, Shangela was up there in the middle of the pack, but so was everyone else. I would say Morgan was the bottom, Trixie was the top, everyone else fell in the middle. In terms of the looks, I really, really loved Trixie's looks. Look, her red, just the librarian theme for red and also reading, it was genius, and it's great for drag queens, and it's great for her type of personality. It looked so polished. It was really well done. I would say I wasn't super excited about any of the other looks. I'm never a big fan of the all one color challenges because it does kind of all blur together, and it's hard to remember specific details, but I would say Trixie's the best. I wouldn't really say anyone had the worst dress out there. I thought Morgan's was really creative. Her kilt and her plaid, I thought it was really neat. Wasn't enough to overcompensate for her performance, but I thought it was a really great look. Now, if we look at who was ranked overall, the tops and the bottoms of the competition, I honestly would say that Trixie was the only one performing at a top level. And I think up until now, we've been picking two tops, and it's always been, for the most part, Bendela and one other person as the second place competitor. And I feel like without Bendela, the rest of them have kind of coasted this episode. Like, oh, well, you know, the main competition's gone. I don't have to try as hard. I really did not see the same level of motivation as I have seen in other challenges from them. I mean, on a lot of other challenges, they've all done well, or they all haven't all done well, but they've always been working really hard. I didn't feel like they were working very hard this challenge. I think it's like, oh, you know what? Valedictorian's gone, so the crown's gonna fall on one of us. Who knows who? They're kind of all on an even playing field, but I think they're all a little too comfortable, and I don't think that they can all rest on that right now. They have a lot still more to do with the rest of the show. In terms of bottom, I agree. Morgan for sure was the bottom, but honestly, it's kind of the same with the performances in general. I think that everyone else just kind of fell in the middle. I didn't see Shangela as a top or performing any more spectacularly than anyone else. I thought editing did her a favor of where the right moments, her very minimal efforts played well into those scenes, but it really wasn't over the top or memorable. It was just kind of, or she did that. It just didn't excite me. And I don't want to be a bummer about this, and I don't want to sound like I'm negative because Bendel is not in the competition anymore. I just do feel like they don't feel threatened anymore, which isn't going to make for great reality TV. So at this point, who do I think's going to win? I think that the strong leaders so far of the competition are Shangela and Trixie. This don't sound mean, but I don't see why BB has made it as far as she has. She's been very low energy. She really hasn't performed much outside the box. Everything has been very much themed around her, like, oh, I'm very regal. And it really surprised me when she said, oh, people think I'm bougie. I don't understand why. Why would someone assign me the queen? Because she projects that kind of an attitude. And I don't think it's a bad thing. I just don't think it's high energy for Drag Race. I personally think Trixie's going to win at this point. The one thing that I worry is about the fan base, because since Bendel, I know I'm talking about her a lot, but since Bendel was such a strong contender and she kind of walked off, it's going to make this win feel less legitimate and a little less lackluster when the main competition's walked away. So I hope that with this next episode, whoever does win really, really showcases their talents and proves it. There needs to be something to help them shine a little bit brighter in order to overcome this kind of like gray area of who is the real winner of All Stars Season 3. And I think that's always going to be called into question no matter who wins. I think it's going to be Trixie. I think I would still be happy if Shangela won. I thought she has been performing really, really well. I think that BB is going to end up in the top three, whether I agree with it or not. I think that she'll be one of the top three contestants. And though Kennedy's been doing a really good job, she's been too all over the board. So I think that that's going to be our top three, and I think that Trixie overall is going to be the winner. That's all for this episode of Nick's Nerd Network. Sorry to keep it so short, guys, but my voice isn't totally back yet, and I look forward to seeing you all again later this week for the season finale. Thanks so much for tuning in. This is Nick's Nerd Network, and I'm Nick.
If you like this episode of Nick's Nerd Network, please like and subscribe. If you have different opinions or would like to share some of your ideas, please share these in the comment section below. Please keep it constructive and friendly. Thanks so much for watching and have a wonderful day.